Can sulforaphane hurt the thyroid?
Hi, I'm Chris Masterjohn, and I have a PhD in nutritional sciences. I am not a medical doctor, and nothing contained in this episode may be construed as medical or nutritional advice of any kind, or a substitute, therefore. This episode is meant purely as scientific education. If you wish to act on any ideas presented in this episode, please consult your physician first, and never take anything herein as a reason to contradict medical advice. With that said, enjoy the episode.
Greg Weber says, sulforaphane is well studied to upregulate the NRF2 pathway. In your masterclass on antioxidants, one of my takeaways was that xenobiotics are beneficial when they upregulate NRF2 more than they cause damage. I agree with that interpretation in my class, Greg. According to this line of reasoning, sulforaphane seems to be the best possible xenobiotic to take since studies show it is very good at upregulating NRF2. Makes sense. Is Dr. Rhonda Patrick right that this is an amazing supplement we should be considering taking? I have seen you state earlier this year that sulforaphane is goitrogenic, correct? And this is consistent with your previous writings on isothiocyanates and crucifers. However, one of the longstanding researchers of sulforaphane, Dr. Jed Fahey, states that this is a misconception of sulforaphane and that they have monitored thyroid status in some studies and see no ill effects. I'm wondering if you have or are planning on taking a deeper look into sulforaphane research or doing writings on the subject. Well, I haven't looked at Fahey's research on this, and so I can't really address what he's saying specifically. What I can say is that sulforaphane does generate isothiocyanate ions, which do inhibit uptake of iodine into the thyroid and mammary gland, although that is a matter of the ratio between isothiocyanate or between thiocyanate ions and iodine. And so, in principle, most uses of sulforaphane in the context of adequate iodine shouldn't be an issue. But at some point, you're going to run it into at some dose, you're going to run into a problem with balancing with iodine, especially in people who have marginal iodine status. But I don't have any studies to back up what point that is. But I have seen cases of people where they got brain fog when they were taking sulforaphane and it went away when they took iodine. So I'm not inclined to say that it's bad because it's goitrogenic, but I am inclined to say, yes, you're right that it's a great NRF2 booster. It should be considered a beneficial supplement in that context. And it does have the drawback that it can inhibit iodine uptake into the thyroid and mammary gland. Enough iodine in the diet should compensate for that. But if you're using high doses, watch out. Take a look at your dietary iodine. Take a look for symptoms of fatigue, brain fog, or anything else that could be tied to hypothyroidism. And if they develop, tweak the sulforaphane and iodine ratio to see what can get rid of them. I'm not against sulforaphane, but I think people should be conscious of the potential downside of it in order to look out for it. So that if things arise, there's an explanation at easy access rather than wondering, why do I feel like crap? So if you feel great on sulforaphane, you probably don't have that issue. You don't have to worry about it. But I do think people should keep in mind that possibility. Thank you, Greg, for your question.
This episode was part of a Q&A for members of the CMJ MasterPass, a buyer's club with exclusive and massive discounts on your favorite premium foods and health products, including pasture-raised and wild meat and seafood, supplements, sleep accessories, water filters, phototherapy devices, and much more. As a bonus, you also get to participate in monthly private Zoom Q&As with me. You can join the MasterPass at chrismasterjohnphd.com/masterpass and use the code Q&A, spelled out as Q-A-N-D-A, Q&A, for a 10% lifetime discount. From now through February or March, whatever it takes to get it done, I will be working full-time on finishing my Vitamins and Minerals 101 book while reserving a portion of my time for my consulting clients. You can pre-order my book at chrismasterjohnphd.com/book. In my consulting, I am neither a medical practitioner nor a coach. I serve as your data analyst and your strategist. I teach you scientific principles of health and wellness, help you analyze your data, and help brainstorm actionable strategies. You can sign up for a consultation at chrismasterjohnphd.com/consultations. I will try to respond to comments here when I can, but my presence will be intermittent while I'm finishing my book. I hope you enjoyed this, and I will see you in the next episode.